Listen,
y'all see, look, I just woke up. Y'all can see my hair is all messed up.
Getting a haircut tomorrow. But anyway, I figured I'd just wake up and come in here and just start, you know, working out some ideas. Say it's supposed to be working right now. That's what's up. Guitar break. Do. Upgraded a legit stretch today. Sweet. Much love. Best R&B teacher. Hey, from Jamaica. Thanks for all you do. That's what's up. Yo, so listen, I'm in here because I have to create some R&B progressions for a few production friends of mine or whatever. So I'm just in here just working out some ideas. Y'all can see, listen, I just woke straight up, came in here, ain't trying to look good or nothing like that. I just came here to work. So it says, I'm a student from college in visual performing arts. It says, Art and My Friends. And I'll be playing. Sweet. So yeah, I'm just in here just working out some ideas. This is the last progression that I was working on, so. Just working out some different ideas, man. Just trying to come up with some stuff that's fresh, some stuff that feels good, some stuff that sounds good. You know, that's just really all I be trying to do. Just make the music feel good, right? You know, while I'm in here, I figured I'd answer some questions, you know what I'm saying? Distorted solo. Not doing any distorted solos right now, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Kerry, can you do a harmonic pinch note in the metal solo? I mean, you could try it, you know what I'm saying? So just in here kind of creating some stuff, I figured like, hey, it's a great opportunity just to come in here and just shed a little bit, work out some ideas and, you know, have you guys here and just answer some questions, you know what I mean? Because you guys are kind of like my peeps, you know what I mean? Let's see what this one is. listen, we got some heat. Man, appreciate it. Appreciate it. Listen, that's how we get the nickname Too Smooth. You know, you gotta live up to it, you know what I'm saying? Tone. So PRS guitar, I put in Lambertone pickup. I didn't put it in, but I had Lambertone Cremas put in there, installed in there. And then I am playing through the Kemper, right? So I'm using this particular profile. And I mean, it sounds great. And I'm going straight into Logic. You know what I mean? Like, nothing fancy, nothing crazy. This is all I'm doing, you know what I mean? So just really just working out some ideas, you know, because setup, this has kind of become one of my primary recording guitars. So I have like a few guitars that I mean, this used to be a live situation, but after I got it, you know, set up how I wanted to, it kind of became like a great studio session guitar. It does great in the studio. And just even for like soloing, whatever, like it definitely has that ability to definitely make it sing. So that's why I like this guitar. It's just definitely versatile. So, like, how many of you guys have, like, guitars that you'd use, like, for live stuff and then guitars that you use for studio session stuff? I'm always kind of wondering, like, what people are using. Or do you use the same guitar for everything? You know, that's one of my questions that I have. And I apologize about this hair. Listen, I just woke up, so I said, yo, the Kerry's Camp interview with LaChaz. Took your suggestions about the Blade Runner. Okay, cool. Oh, really? So, Robert, so it really does work. Okay, cool. That's what's up. I got a Strat that I think I may try to do that on, too. So, that's what's up. That's what's up. I'm glad that you're taking the advice that you're hearing from different people. This week, we have Kingfish that's going to be speaking to you guys. So, I'm really excited. Strats for recording and a Les Paul to perform. I feel you. What's your favorite pentatonic scale for soloing? What's my favorite pentatonic scale? It doesn't matter what key. I play in all keys, so I don't have a favorite pentatonic scale for soloing. Yeah, I feel you. So the Les Paul, I outserved the Les Paul with these same pickups, and I put a Bigsby on it, and it's really become one of my, these two, the Les Paul and this one, have really become like my favorite session guitars. So I've taken them off the road. They're like session specialists. So whenever I gotta do sessions, I usually bring out those two, unless the client is just like, yo, I want something more of a Strat feel. Then of course, then I'll play a Strat guitar. Now I used to use my guitar with all the stickers on it for like primarily for soloing, but since I put the same pickups in these guitars, I don't have to go to that one. That's still one of my performance guitars whenever I, you know, have any kind of shows per se. I do have some guitars that are coming that I'm really excited about. This one guitar from Japan looks super dope. I've never seen anything like it or played anything like it. Well, I take it back. I have played the 513. Reminds me kind of the 513 with the pickup configuration. I've never heard of those particular guitars, Daniel. So, but yeah, so this guitar is from Japan and it has the HSH setup. So, but it also looks like it also has a Jazzmaster configuration where it can take certain pickups out of phase. So I'm eager to try it out. Then I also have the Raven that's coming from Tom Anderson that I'm really excited about. Because that one I got a chance to build from the ground up. So prayerfully next month they should be coming through. So we'll just see. You never know. Also too, if you're brand new to this channel, like, can you just do me a favor and subscribe? I would love for you to be a part of this community. Click the bell to be notified, because from time to time I'll be doing these different lives at various times throughout the day. So I know y'all probably like, man, he like super, super early. But I realize there's people all over the world that be watching YouTube at different times and you never know. So I'll be trying to catch the wave, as you will. You know what I mean? So the king of soul and R&B. I gladly wear that crown. I gladly wear that crown. So, you know what I mean? I woke up this morning. I wanted to hop in here and just come jam out real quick. Just, you know, nothing crazy, nothing insane. But just wanted to work on some stuff because today's the deadline. I gotta have some stuff in, so I've been sending some stuff all week, but I wanted to kind of top it off with a few more jams. You know what I mean? Best way to get into R&B playing, is to sign up for my course, kerryskamp.com, kerryskamp.com, and that way I can show you exclusively, regardless of whatever level you are, how to play R&B. If you're a beginner, if you're intermediate or advanced, we got something that's gonna definitely help you grow in your craft. Peace, love, God blessing. I'm buying an acoustic guitar. Oh, sweet, I'm subscribed. What kind of acoustic guitar are you getting? What are some good R&B songs to transcribe? You can listen to 90s R&B, man, there's plenty of stuff. And if you go on Spotify and you type in R&B playlist, you got plenty of stuff, man. You'll find all types of stuff. That's usually what I do. I go find or listen to different R&B artists. From there, stuff that I don't even know. They got like chill R&B stuff that people I've never heard of before that has some cool stuff. So there's plenty of options that you can go listen to different, you know, vibes and transcribe their stuff. How long have you been playing guitar? I've been playing guitar well over 20 years. Jam on, brother. Love the sound. Appreciate it. Yeah. Thoughts on compression. I mean, I think compression is good. Some people use it, some people don't. It's just personal preference. When playing CCM, do you add R&B to it? Not all the time, because you want to be authentic to the genre, right? So if I'm playing like some distort, like some CCM. I might do like some different kind of R&B riff. Love your playing. I appreciate that. You have really been helping me out and to become a better guitarist, and I really appreciate you. Appreciate it. I mean, that's why I do what I do. Like, I want to give back and try to help others. I was hoping you could give me some suggestions on my first guitar as a beginner. Donner Guitars, man. I did a review on Donner Guitars. It would definitely be a great first starter. That way you're not, you know, spending that much money. One amp is that profile bass up? I don't know. Tone Junkies gave me like a whole bunch of profiles, Ken. And so I don't know. I think the Silver Jubilee, I mean, maybe the AC-130. I don't know for sure. I can't answer that because it doesn't say specifically. Thanks for your knowledge. Love your playing. Which guitarist do you look up to? I like Tim Stewart. I like Eric Walls. I like Mark Lethierry. Those are some, you know what I mean? Jubu, for sure. I'll tap in with them about it. Sweet. Can you give me some basic exercises to practice, please, daily? If you're a camper, I have a whole list of practice stuff that you can do. So you should sign up to Kerry's Camp. I have stuff that'll like keep you busy and help you grow in your craft. And you'll start to see really a lot of improvement in your playing. So go to kerryscamp.com, KerrysKamp.com. Yeah, I do like the pick that I have. I'm still using it. So, yeah. And I even bought some. That's when you know you really like something, is when you're willing to spend your own money. Does the number system work with the minor scale too? I don't use it for the minor scale, it's because it can be confusing. And honestly, the universal language around the world, nobody really refers to the minor scale when using the number system. So I'm sure it could work, but that's not what you're doing it for. What's up, Mr. Red? Let's do this. Just because I want to play some Jilly from Philly. Is that cool? Can I do that? All right, let's look at some The Way. Ba ba ba. The Way, my dude. Jilly from Philly. Thank you. it the way. Oh my goodness. I feel like a radio DJ right now. All right, let's go answer some of these questions. The streams on Kerry's Corner are dope. Yo, that's what we try to do. We try to have like some dope interviews with a lot of dope people. Just ordered Lambertone pickups. I also have the gospel R&B course. Sweet, sweet. That's what's up. What's up, bro? Hey, you really been digging your YouTube shorts lately, man. I'm trying to just, you know, we trying this. You know, my team suggested it, so we trying to do a little something. what cats blaze through the fretboard, Jabari Johnson? Are they picking every note? You have to ask Jabari. I can't honestly tell you exactly what he's doing. What's your favorite scale to solo in? Favorite scale? I wouldn't say I have a favorite scale. One of my go-to scales that I use a lot of time is the minor pentatonic, hence why I taught a lesson about how you can use the minor pentatonic to prick out the melodies. You know what I'm saying? Are you gonna pick up a Great Dane? Honestly, man, I want to, but with having a brand new daughter, I don't know if that's the best thing to do right now. You know what I'm saying? I already have one dog. I don't know if I want to get another one and have to deal with, you know, puppies, and it's a lot. you're real smooth. But on the lesson, can you play some music? Man, you're versatile. Can you play some shout music? I have some shout music on the gospel masterclasses, Warren, so you gotta definitely check those out. So this is what I'll do, because I haven't, I mean, honestly, I mean, I don't really play a lot of shout music because the church that I go to, they don't really focus in on shout music. So let me see, I think I have a shout track somewhere. Let me see if I can find it for you. I ain't played shout music in a long time. Oh man, let me see if I can find some more shout tracks. Ah man, it's been a long time. You really gotta be immersed in shout music. That's why I don't really teach a lot of shout music, because that's not really my strong point, because I don't really do that in church anymore. Oh man, that's your little light coat. I don't really, because the church I play at, man, we don't really do shout, so that's not really my vibe anymore. Amen. My vibe is more different things, you know what I'm saying? Let's go back to some other stuff that I had. Your daughter looks so cute. Appreciate it. She's adorable. Saw her on Instagram. Appreciate it. Thank you for the suggestion. I would definitely look into getting a Donner. Yeah, Donner makes some really dope guitars, and they're inexpensive when you're first starting out. So watching from Western Australia, that's what's up, man. Appreciate it. Asked you seriously played guitar for Ty Dolla $ign, Sean Kingston, and Jason Derulo, by the way. Respect you, bro. I heard you went from fighting. I never fought in Iran, in Iraq, though. I gotta ask you, seriously played. Yes, I seriously played for Ty Dolla $ign, and I seriously played for Big Sean, and I seriously played for, I'm not Big Sean, Sean Kingston, and I played for Jason Derulo. You could probably go find some clips of me performing on YouTube. There's plenty of stuff. Love from Brazil. Cool. I want to learn arpeggios too, but I don't know where to start. Johnny, if you want to learn arpeggios, I have some lessons in Kerry's Camp. Kerryscamp.com, KerryScamp.com. You should definitely check it out. What's up from South Australia? Arpeggios are simple, though. It's not nothing that's like out of your wheelhouse. Where in progressions are the best place to use diminished chords as a passing to add flavor? So Christopher, if you become a camper, I have all lessons that talk about that show you really really show you, because just me giving you like a once over, I can tell you, but you something that you got to watch constantly. So you should definitely check out kerryscamp.com, KerryskamP.com. My man, love what you do for the guitar community. I'm getting so much out of the R&B beginners. Oh, sweet, man. That's what it's all about. What's up from Singapore? Yo, that's what's up. Would you be willing to offer a guest speaker who's a singer guitarist for those who are singer songwriters wanting to learn, just to share the experience accompanying themselves? Would you be willing to offer a guest speaker? I would have to see who that person is. Like, I mean, because it just depends on who you're talking about, like who the guest speaker would be. Because I'm really particular about the people that I have on the platform, because I want to make sure that they identify with the stuff that we're talking about, you know. So it's just, I would have to like see what person you suggest. We'll check it out. It says, random question. Do you have a favorite movie? Yeah, Sandlot. I love Sandlot. It's one of my all-time favorite movies. People that know me, like, well, like, especially somebody that's getting on my nerves, I'd be like, man, you're killing me, Smalls. I said it all the time. Maybe late to the convo. I was wondering what kind of picks is that purple one. So this is called, this is by Moog Street. So this pick is like their medium. I think it's just their medium. I don't know what the exact name of it is, but this is by Moog Street or Boog Street. I'm sorry, Boog Street or Bog Street, however you pronounce it, B-O-G. By the way, could you do a cover of a song like Go? I've never heard of it, but you know, at some point I may get to it. Is there a specific pattern for finger picking, index finger? No, there's not a specific pattern. Everybody teaches different kind of techniques. I always tell my campers, do what works best for you, what feels most comfortable, because if it doesn't feel comfortable, then you're probably not gonna duplicate it again. Is your link that says for beginner something that can be for somebody who has never played? When it says beginner, that's what it means. Like, you've never seen a guitar before, so we can definitely help you out, so. Let's get into some Joe. I wanna know. That's enough of that Joe for this morning. That's enough. Listen, I'm just warming up. So I had a few things that came in. Let's see. We talked about that already. Thank you. Is your link? We talked about that already. Did you start off on a strutting rock guitar. No, I never started out. I was straight quartet. That's how I started out. Or did you went straight from R&B playing? I started straight out playing quartet, and then I morphed into R&B. For the guest singer, I meant whoever you want, like how you would bring on a guest. I would definitely have to find somebody that fits that singer-songwriter that's open, you know what I mean? I had to find somebody that, but that could definitely be cool. Can you play on Put a Spell on You? Sure, if that's what I want to do, but I don't think that's what I want to do right now. I'm in my R&B bag this morning, my old 90s R&B. This playing is helping me out. Any tutorials on the slide movements? You can, anything, slide movements, trills, any of that stuff is already in Kerry's Camp. So you should definitely check it out. Kerry'sCamp.com, KerysKamp.com. How do you feel about thumb picks? I think they're cool. They just don't work for me. Like, some people can use them. Like, I know one prominent player that I love that plays with a thumb pick is Eric Walls, but I tried it. I can't do it. What was it like playing for Tori Kelly? It was phenomenal, man. Honestly, like, it was cool. It was a she's a musician, so she lets the guitarists or lets the musicians play. She's very musical. She's got a very humble spirit, but you got to know what you're doing, though. You just, you know, come in prepared. If you know what you're doing, then of course, then every time you work with any artist, it's always cool. But if you don't know what you're doing, then it can get a little tricky, get a little salty. You know what I mean? You'll do a tutorial on that Joe song. If I haven't already done it, then I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure I've already done it. Would you say that learning jazz theory would help get me an R&B plan? Not necessarily. Jazz is a different, totally different animal, Johnny. To do so, I would definitely say it won't get you necessarily into playing R&B. Gospel probably more so than jazz. You know what I mean? Yo, I'm gonna take a couple more questions and then I gotta get ready because I gotta finish up, you know what I mean? Besides the obvious, what are the major differences between secular music and gospel churchy folks? Lyrics, and then sometimes it could be like chord progressions, you know what I'm saying? That's probably one of the things. When cats blaze through the fretboard, i.e. like Jabari Johnson, are they picking every note? W. Smalls, you would have to ask him. I'm not sitting up analyzing. That's not who I am. I'm not one of these guys that sit up here and just analyzes all these other videos. And there's no shade against people that do that. I'm hella busy myself and I'm working on content and I'm teaching people, so I don't have the time to sit up here and like analyze what another player is doing. If you want to know what they're doing, you should probably reach out and ask them. I'm pretty sure that they'll answer for you. You know what I mean? One thing I love about the camp, I've learned so many things. I can turn on most R&B songs and vibe to them on spot. That's what it's about, finding a key. Robert, you've tapped in. Robert, you have the force. The force is strong with you. All right, I'm gonna take one more question, then I gotta get ready to finish working. Those little runs you did in between, I want to know, is there a specific technique? So Mook, if you watch the YouTube video where I talked about how to solo, I'm just using those same techniques. I just played the solo, like I wanna know. I just play like the lyrics. That's all I'm doing. On your gospel courses, you use the black cloth down from the top of your guitar. Wanted to know what it was. What was the purpose? Backdrop. Because that apartment that I was in, my team suggested that I use it as a backdrop because they wanted to put various like different kind of graphics. So that's all it was. It was just a backdrop. Backdrop is just a black cloth. Thanks for the knowledge, Kerry. You rock. Appreciate it. All right, man. I love y'all, man. Y'all have a good one. I got to get ready to go. Peace. Talk to you guys tomorrow.